Okay, everybody, we are going to do a really quick. Here is a book. Thanks for joining me. 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership. So, there is. Let me flip it around really. Hey, everybody. Okay, two in one night. I was feeling like I wanted to get this done. Okay, there is apparently a challenge that's going on. Yay, everybody that's doing that. That's awesome. Okay, a lot of people have messaged me yesterday and today, and I'm feeling a little bit overwhelmed and got lots and lots and lots of messages. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to read these John Maxwell questions and get them answered for all of you. And then everybody will have the answer, and I'll feel better because I will be able to kill two birds with one stone and get all these messages caught up on. So if you know somebody, maybe you can jump on Facebook and let them know that I'm going to be sharing the answers to four questions. It is out of page 32 of this workbook, John Maxwell, The Irrefutable Laws of Leadership. So you sent me a friend request. I'm going to look at that. That was probably number 1044. I'll go look. Unfortunately, I'm so sorry. I've kind of avoided the friends request list just because it's a mess. But I'm reaching my 5,000 limit, so I don't pay attention to that much. Okay, so question number one. What made you decide to enter the field in which you are currently successful? That is a very good question. And again, I got lots and lots of these Facebook messages, so I'm just going to cover it really, really quickly and get all of them answered at once. So just so you guys know, I was a registered nurse. I worked as a nurse for over, gosh, 11 years and absolutely loved it. I knew I wanted to be a nurse because I knew I wanted to help people and really enjoyed it. I did intensive care, and that's where I met my husband. And then I switched over to labor and delivery, which that was very, very rewarding. Now, what was not so rewarding was the 12-hour night shifts. It was stressful and didn't make for good family life. My husband's a nurse anesthetist. So I currently am a network marketer, and I did not choose that. It kind of found me. I found some products that I loved and had some really good results, and kind of accidentally stumbled on this business opportunity that I didn't even realize was out there. So, how did I decide to enter this field? I didn't decide. It kind of found me, and I'm very, very glad that it found me because network marketing has been such a tremendous blessing for our family. So, didn't choose it. It chose me, and boy, am I glad. Who have been some of your mentors? That's question number two. First off, I have to say I have the most amazing and wonderful, loving parents ever. So my mom and dad have been the ones who have said, you know, dream big, reach for the stars, you can do anything, you know, anything that you want. So to have amazing parents, thank you very much, to have amazing parents that could be mentors for me has just been a huge, huge blessing. So I couldn't do anything without them. Oh, thank you so much for finding me on YouTube. That's kind of how everything started, is jump on YouTube and get a few questions answered, and then hopefully you guys can benefit from that. So thank you so much for mentioning that. But I reached a point in my business where I realized I need to find somebody who's 10 steps ahead of me, 20 steps ahead of me. Who can I learn from? Who can I listen to? I prayed really hard that I would find some great mentors and coaches that could help me in my business. I stumbled on this book, Rock Your Network Marketing Business by Sara Robbins, and it just spoke to me. It was like, oh my gosh, this is exactly what I've been looking for. So I was able to feel like I was getting mentored through starting my personal growth and development journey with reading books. That's really where it started. And then through Facebook messages, I've been able to develop a friendship with Sara Robbins. So she has been a huge influence in helping me to move forward in my success. She's you know, in network marketing, she's extremely successful. It's a Sarah thing. Very good. Hey, Sarah, how are you? That's funny. So yes, it really was great to be able to find somebody who was so many steps ahead of me saying, this is what I learned, this is how I learned it. And that was really, really exciting for me. After having that relationship form with Sarah Robbins, she introduced me to Art Jonek. He has been a wonderful, wonderful mentor to me. So thank you very much, Art. And Art opened up a relationship and introduced me to, yeah, it's hard when you loan them out. You got to order extras. I think I have 5 copies at any given time to be able to loan out and give to people. It's a wonderful, wonderful book. But it really, really is important to seek out mentors and people who can help you along the way. Orrin Woodward has been wonderful for me, mostly through his books, but we have had a few conversations that have been extremely helpful. So I think mentors and coaches are so important to have in your life. Okay, question number 3. What 5 books have made the greatest impact on your leadership? Number 1, the last chapter in here. Oh no, chapter 9, Preparing Yourself to Lead, is wonderful. It's a really, really, really great. And then she also has the Masterclass Edition audios that are wonderful, that have been very helpful for me. So I would say that's the first one. And then I'm going to flip this around and I'm going to show you. Look, I've got a pile of books on the floor. I've got a pile of books here. I've got a pile of books here. So I have to tell you guys, this book right here, Launching a Leadership Revolution, Chris Brady and Orrin Woodward, they are amazing leadership guys. So if you have not found stuff by Orrin Woodward and you're looking for some great leadership stuff, definitely check that out. This one right here, Resolved. This is Resolved Primer, but there's actually a thicker one, just the full Resolved, again by Orrin Woodward. This is an amazing leadership book. Anything by John Maxwell. Of course, we're answering questions from this book, which I have the full audio of that book and absolutely love. Now, let me know if y'all are still with me. I'm losing people on the chat. John Maxwell, Here's Today Matters, which is a great book. The thing about John Maxwell, look, the Leadership Bible, y'all, you can't go wrong with the Leadership Bible. The thing about John Maxwell is he's got so many. Look at all these. Okay, here's one of them. Hello, thanks. Hey, Lisa, thanks for jumping on. Okay, the Daily Reader. And this kind of goes into question number 5. But even if you only have 5 minutes a day, great, thank you so much. Even if you only have 5 minutes a day, like this John Maxwell Daily Reader, you can get a 5-minute dose of leadership and inspiration just from flipping through this. Yes, that John Maxwell Bible is awesome. I highly, highly recommend it. So here, you can just pick the date that you're on. This is kind of like a devotional type thing, and you get 5 minutes worth of your leadership stuff. So there's Resolve. There's the full copy of it, not just the primer. This is amazing. Orrin Woodward said with this one, this is 13 resolutions for life. This would be basically, if he's going to sit down and personally coach you, what would he share? So you really can be coached by somebody without having a conversation with them if you take to personal growth and development. So let's look at these chapters really quick. So for Resolve, how character, attitude, vision. Those are all really, really important things. So I absolutely love Orrin Woodward. There's another John Maxwell. And I just ordered, just so you know, I'm kind of a nerd, a book nerd. Oh, just ordered this one and have just started this one. So this is the new one that I'm currently working on. So I don't know why. There we go. Okay. So just so you know, I think it's always good to have something new and exciting to stay coachable. I'm always ordering new things. Yes, I got most of them on Amazon. Sarah Robbins has her own website, Sarah Robbins with an H.com/store. One that I don't have because I lent out that's been very helpful to me is Millionaire by Halftime, and that is www.presleyswaggerty.com. And so that's also a very good book that has some great chapters on leadership and team culture and stuff like that. So I'm sorry, that's more than 5 books, but I'm kind of obsessed with books. Last question, what daily learning or self-improvement habits do you have? That's a very, very good question. I used to watch 2 hours of TV at night. So I had the DVR or TiVo or whatever you want to say, and I would sit down and I would watch American Idol and Parenthood and The Good Wife. I had, you know, my regular programs. So the kids would get put to bed and I had me time. And I thought, okay, this is time that I deserve. So I'm going to sit down and decompress and unwind. And then I started this wonderful network marketing thing and realized I was in over my head and I needed to know, hey, Jen, needed to know what I should be doing. Yes, the Presley Swaggerty's new one, Be, Do, and Have More. I have not read that one yet, but I've heard really, really good things about it. So anyway, self-improvement habits, I wasn't doing anything for self-improvement. And I realized that when I traded that entertainment time for education time, that it started to serve me very well because I was given the tips, the tools, the training, the information that I needed to be successful in my business. So I did have the time, I just wasn't allocating that time appropriately for what I needed to help take my business to the next level. So I have to tell you, it's been 2 years since I gave up. You can't see, I can't show you anything else because my office is an absolute mess. Scoot the camera. I had somebody say that the other day. I can see fine on my phone. I don't know why the view is different for some people. But like I said, you can't see the rest of my messy office. So I'm not sure if it's your little picture view or mine. You see my whole head. Okay. Well, that's very nice to know. Okay. I think it might just be the view that some people have. I'm not sure why it does that. So anyway, I traded the television time for book and reading time, and I've not missed TV at all. It's been 2 years since I watched any of those shows. On occasion, I'll watch House Hunters when they do the beachfront beach homes, because that's on my dream board, is to have a beach house one day. So very, very rarely. Oh, very good. Okay, you're learning. Okay, thanks for pointing that out, guys. Very rarely do I watch television, and you'll find me usually in the evenings with one of these books. And I'm telling you, investing in personal growth and development has increased my belief significantly. And I really feel like that is what's kept me going and moving forward in my business. When I've hit those roadblocks, those stumbling blocks, whatever the case may be, it's because I'm reading and listening and associating with successful, mentors and people that can help my vision and my belief. So I'm gonna flip the camera back around because I did talk about the leadership ones, but I want to share with you three more books. Okay. So we talked about all the leadership ones. So I'm going to put all the leadership ones away. Now, when I started my personal growth and development journey and didn't know a darn thing about network marketing, like I said, this is my number one recommendation. If I'm going to give something to my team or my new people that join, this is definitely going to be it, Sara Robbins. One of the very first books that I read about network marketing was For Your Career. And this is a really, really good book that's just going to give you some information, some statistics, and some stories about why is network marketing so amazing. Next up, Flip Flop CEO. This is written, it's similar to The 4-Year Career in that it talks about why network marketing is so amazing, but this is written by some amazing gals. Again, it's why is it so great, but then it's got, at the very back, it's got stories of people who have been successful, and it's a wonderful, wonderful book, and you may or may not find my story in one of those pages. It's in there, but I'm not sure where. If you have not read this, a new friend that I have, Wes Linden, that I met at the Mastermind event, this is an awesome book, and he's got the audio to that as well. Some tips, network marketing tips. GoPro was one of the first ones that I read that I really enjoyed. And then this, Making the First Circle Work by Randy Gage. This, I was like, oh my gosh, where has this been? It's short, it's sweet. I think it's only, look, it's 75 pages. It's practical. It's just an amazing, this is why network marketing is so awesome. So these are kind of my top ones that I read. That's kind of it. I'm losing some of you. I know it's kind of drawn out. I try to keep my Periscope shorter than this, but I hope that's helpful with the answers to the workbook. That was just for whatever, page 32, whatever chapter that was on. I apologize if I have not gotten to your questions from chapters 1, 2, 3. I had a lot of other messages from everybody that's doing this. I'm really, really excited at the number of people who are doing this leadership challenge and using the 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership by John Maxwell. So keep up the good work. I'm very proud of you. Thanks for jumping on Periscope. Thanks for all the hearts. Tap, 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 tap. I love seeing, I've just got purple and pink right there now. Sometimes you've got some yellow and green and orange, lots of different things. So I have had so many people ask, you know, oh my gosh, I missed your Periscope and they're only up for 24 hours. Some of the top ones that I've gotten the most hearts with, I have dumped over to a playlist called Sara J Replay on YouTube. So if we get lots of love and lots of hearts, you may be able to find this recording over on youtube.com/Sara J Marble. I think I put four over there, just some of the ones that everybody was asking about that they had missed. So if you missed one, or if you want to share it with a friend, check out YouTube. And thank you guys so much. And I hope you have an awesome evening. Talk to you soon.